Florida, Center for the Performing Arts. It's a 1998 Miss Florida pageant. Hello, I'm Carl Dunn with Pageantry Magazine. All of us here are awaiting the arrival of our judges, celebrity guests, and very special guest star. You know, this is the first time the event's been held here in Gainesville, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. You're in for a spectacular evening. As our limos arrive, which they're doing right now, let's take a peek inside and see who's arriving. Arriving with our panel of judges. Yes, it is. Our first judge is Mary Lou Lewis. Mary Lou has been a volunteer in the Miss America organization for 36 years, principally with the Miss Wisconsin program. She has served as the associate producer of Miss Wisconsin, producer, and is currently editor of the Miss Wisconsin pageant newsletter. Our next judge is Michael Disselhorst. Michael has been with the Miss Iowa Starship program since 1992. Jerry Gardner is a restaurateur from Arkansas. He operates three steakhouses and TGI Fridays in Fort Smith, Arkansas. As our second limo arrives, let's take another peek inside and see who awaits our public. Our next judge is Helen Lovner. Helen was born in Lima, Peru, and educated in South America. She spends time doing philanthropic events and is the CEO of a multi-million dollar real estate venture. Bob Ritchie was our final judge out of the limo. He's a career representative for Johnson's, and he's official photographer of Miss Georgia for the past 24 years. Everyone's favorite president, Marie Fennell. Marie's the president of the Miss Florida Board of Directors, and I believe arriving with her is the reigning Miss Florida, Christy Newman, which is always a favorite with the crowd. She's a preliminary talent winner and top 10 finalist at last year's Miss America pageant in Atlantic City. Our next guest to arrive is the executive producer, Anthony Luizzo, and his family. He's an executive producer of the Miss Florida program. He's the owner and developer of our host hotel here in Gainesville, the University Center Hotel. He's joined by his wife, Suzanne, and daughter Sabrina. And once again, we have our celebrity host, Miss Debbie Turner. Debbie is Miss America in 1990. She currently hosts two shows, The Dental Doctor and Show Me St. Louis. The Miss America program allowed Debbie the unique opportunity of pursuing her dreams of becoming a doctor of veterinary medicine. And our very special guest, everyone's favorite genie, Barbara Eden. Barbara is well known for her starring role with Lori Hagman in I Dream of Jeannie, which had a successful run for 5 years. She has a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame and her own production company. Barbara has been featured many times on the cover of Pageantry Magazine.
Florida pageant is brought to you by the Florida Lottery. When you play, we all win. By budget, low rates by the day, weekend or longer. By the parents at Anheuser-Busch. By Regions Bank. When it comes to trust, you can bank on Regions Bank. The stars always shine at the University Center Hotel.
Thank you. South Florida. Cancun, Miss University of Central Florida, a student at the University of Central Florida.
Jamie Riney, Miss Polk County, a student at Florida Southern College.
Me and you, Kung Fu fighting, dancing queen. We are live here at the University of Florida Center for Performing Arts. We have 39 beautiful contestants that are going to compete their hearts out for you this evening. But right now, it is my great pleasure to introduce to you a legend of stars and screen. You probably remember as the beautiful genie of I Dream of Jeannie. Ladies and gentlemen, my co-host for the evening, Miss Barbara Eden.
Good evening. I am so excited to be part of the crowning of Miss Florida of 1998. You know, Debbie, I'm no stranger to stage or television, but this is the first time I have ever participated in a Miss America scholarship pageant. It's very exciting for me.
Well, you are in for an exciting evening. Let me tell you, at least our job this evening is a piece of cake. The contestants have the work to do.
Yes,
we have
they do.
The fun to
yes,
do.
They do.
We are so thrilled to have you with us. And I know everyone would be really interested in knowing what you've been up to since you were Jeannie.
Oh, boy, since I was Jeannie.
Yeah.
It's a few years now, Debbie.
I know it's been a few years. Let me just ask you this question. Do you ever walk around the house and you want something and you go like that?
Of course. Yeah. Of course.
Does anything happen?
Oh, of course.
Oh,
of course it does.
Okay, so what have you been doing?
Well, I right now I do television movies. I do a couple a year, and I usually go out and do a stage production. The last one I did was Gentlemen Prefer Blondes, and about two yeah, it was fun.
They love you.
And about 2 weeks ago, I was back in my pink pajamas and my bottle again.
Were you really?
Yeah.
Speaking of that bottle, do you keep that laying around the house, the same bottle that you did the show with?
Yes, I do, but I keep the cork out.
Oh, okay.
I don't.
Easier to get in and out, right?
Don't get me in that thing. No.
Well, it is so wonderful to have you with us. We are in for an exciting evening, so don't go away. We will be right back.
Tonight, we'd like to recognize three contestants who've demonstrated exceptional service to their communities.
That is absolutely right. The second runner-up receives a $500 scholarship, and this award goes to Miss North Miami, Christy Mascaretto.
The first runner-up and winner of a $1,000 cash scholarship is Miss Volusia County, Katherine Johnson.
And the winner of the Community Service Award and recipient of a $2,000 cash scholarship is Miss Tri-County, Kelly Meyer-Henry.
Awards a $1,000 scholarship for academic excellence. The recipient of the academic award is Miss Florida State University, Megan Berry.
And the recipient of the Miss America Community Service Award, winner of another $1,000 scholarship, is Miss Daytona Beach, Stephanie Glock. Congratulations to all of you ladies for being so involved in your community. Keep up the good work. All right, let's go on to our Miss Florida right now, 1997, Christy Newman. Christy.
The Miss Florida Scholarship Pageant is proudly supported by the Florida Lottery. When you play, we all win. Barbara?
And now, the moment we've all been waiting for, the announcement of the top 10 semifinalists.
That's right, these ladies are the 10 contestants with the highest number of points after the three nights of preliminary competition. May I have the envelope, please? Barbara, do a drum roll.
Do a I can bark, too.
You got to roll along with that. They're taking a little while.
Did I tell you I can wiggle my ears?
No. Well,
oh, yeah, I can wiggle my ears.
Okay.
I don't know if they...
I can see it. Take my word for it. She just did it.
That's my whole repertoire.
I can't believe now I expected to have to fill at the end of the show as we were waiting for the results of the crowning of the new Miss Florida, but the top 10 I didn't expect to have to wait for.
Well, if you think we're feeling nervous, think about those young ladies in back of us.
Well, I tell you what. That's right. How you ladies doing? You hanging in there? You holding up?
You bet. They should all win.
I tell you what. I happen to have in my card, you got to give me a second to get to it, a list. It's for later on in the competition, but we'll use it to make the announcement, okay?
We will?
Yes. Tell us about Larry Hagman and what it's like to work with him while I find this in my card.
Oh,
okay?
Gee, Debbie, thanks.
Come on, Barbara, fill it for me. Help me out here.
You're a sport. In 10 words or less, you mean?
Give me 15 words.
Oh, well,
go
Larry
ahead,
Hagman.
Go.
Larry Hagman, let me see. He's a wonderful, wonderful man. Yes, he is, and very talented, and I loved working with him. I have many stories, but they take too long.
All right, here we go. I found it later on in my card. Ladies and gentlemen, these are your top 10 semifinalists. One of these ladies will be your new Miss Florida by the end of the evening.
Oh, you had
Thank
it?
Thank you.
Oh, she had it
God
all this
bless
time.
Bless your soul. All right, here we go. Gosh, he's sweaty from having just danced.
Hey.
Our first semifinalist is Miss Azalea Allison Leary.
Yay! Let me do it. The second semifinalist, Carrie Schrader, Miss Tampa. Okay.
And our third semifinalist is Miss Seminole Susan Holstenbach.
Fourth semifinalist, Miss Palm Beach County, Kelly Gaudet.
Huh? And our next semifinalist is Miss Winter Park, Christy Sheffield.
Our sixth semifinalist, Miss Miami, Lisette Gonzalez.
Congratulations goes out to Miss South Florida Fair, Robin Sprague.
Semifinalist, Miss University of Miami, Mia Matrioni.
And come on down, Miss Florida State University, Megan Barron.
And number 10, Miss Tallahassee, Shauna Pender.
Congratulations to all of these ladies and to all of our contestants. You have done a fine job, and we are proud of you. To our top 10 semifinalists, one of these ladies will be Miss Florida by the end of the evening and will represent the Sunshine State at the Miss America pageant in September in Atlantic City.
And before the competition begins, let's explain the scoring system our judges will use.
All preliminary scores will be discarded, except for the private interview, which took place earlier this week. That score will carry over and make up the first 30% of tonight's score. Tonight's swimsuit competition will account for 15%, the talent portion will make up 30%, and evening wear will count for 15%. Then our top five contestants will be asked another set of questions relating to current issues and their platform. This crucial interview will round out tonight's score with the final 10%. So if you're doing your own scoring at home, now's the time to grab a pencil and paper, because the fun's just beginning.
Space is all the rage. From blockbusters like Deep Impact to Armageddon, everyone is exploring the final frontier. Tonight, our Miss Florida dancers get lost in space.
Leanza Cornett. I was Miss Florida 1992 and Miss America 1993. I'm still using my scholarship winnings to earn my degree in communications, but in the meantime, I'm co-hosting a show called New Attitudes on Lifetime Television. Coming up next is swimsuit competition. Enjoy.
Contest, the swimwear competition, which is worth 15% of the score. Now, the judges are looking for the contestants' overall fitness and health, and they're also looking for poise and confidence. Now, it is true, these contestants are tan, tone, and looking good, but if you think they're just pretty faces with a great body, you must be out of your mind, Jellyhead.
I want to be shining in the mirror. Her salute on point to the ballet Stars and Stripes is Miss Tampa, Carrie Schrader.
Will sing the inspiring gospel song, His Eye is on the Sparrow. She believes if he sees the fallen sparrow, he watches you and me. Please welcome Miss Seminole, Susan Holsenbach.
Why should I feel discouraged? Why should the shadow fall?
stage, Miss Palm Beach County, Kelly Gaudette.
Innocent time, and remember falling in love to this 1960s Mel Carter classic. Here to help you remember that special moment, singing Hold Me, Thrill Me, Kiss Me, is Miss Winter Park, Christy Sheffield. And love of others. In order to make it, we need at least one person who believes in us when no one else will. For Christy Newman and me, that person has been our moms. They have been our role models, our friends, our mentors.
they have been the wind beneath our wings. It must have been cool there in your shadow to never have sunlight in your face. You were content to let me shine unless you were.
Performing a song about determination and inspiration, our next contestant will present her rendition of Don't Rain on My Parade. Please welcome Miss Miami, Lisette Gonzalez.
Don't tell me not to live, just sit and putter. Life's candy and the sun's a ball of butter. Don't bring on a cloud to rain on my parade. Don't tell me not to fly, it's simply not true. If someone takes a spill, it's me and not you. Who told you're allowed to rain on my parade? All my friends ticket had her. I guess I didn't make it yet. Ready for me, world, cause I'm a comer. I simply got a march by heart to drummer. Nobody, no, nobody is gonna rain on my parade.
Drumming since the age of 5, and a former world baton twirling champion, our next contestant will perform a high-energy twirling routine to the popular Latin song Cha-Cha-Cha. Please welcome Miss South Florida Fair, Robin Sprague.
Of Nobody Does It Like Me from the Broadway musical Seesaw, here is University of Miami, Mia Mastrioni.
Big loud mouth, I'm always talking much too free.
contestant will perform a lyrical pantomime dance to It's Oh So Quiet. Please welcome Miss Florida State University, Megan Berry.
Reinvent themselves, remaining timeless throughout the decades. Here to stir your souls with River Deep, Mountain High is Miss Tallahassee, Shauna Pender.
When I was a little girl, I had a rag doll, only doll I've ever owned. Now I love you just the way
by the Florida Lottery. When you play,
Winter Park, Christy Sheffield.
Thank you.
I feel that is how I will go.
Have tabulated the judges' scores, rather, and the contestants with the five highest scores now become tonight's finalists. May I have the envelope, please? Please tell me it's ready. Woo! Let's have a round of applause for the envelope, ladies and gentlemen. Yes! Thank you, Lord. And these are the five finalists that will compete for the title of Miss Florida. Our first finalist is Megan Berry.
Yeah.
congratulations to Lizette Gonzalez. Our fourth finalist is Kelly Gaudet. And our final finalist this evening is Robin Sprague. Congratulations.
One of the best things about Busch Gardens is how close you can get to the animals.
Better?
Oh, yes.
Well, now you're in for it. All right, Megan, your first question. Your career choice is to be a professional entertainer in movies, TV, and Broadway. Which one would be your first choice and why?
Well, I would really love to be on television. I feel that it's wonderful to be a part of someone's everyday life and be able to switch on TV and someone say, oh, look, I love her. She's my idol or something like that. I look up to a lot of people on TV and I want to be that someone that people can sit down and relax and watch. Thank you.
Good answer, yeah. Second question. Are you for or against women in the military being assigned to combat duty?
I am definitely for women being assigned to combat. I feel that women should be given the same opportunities as men. Therefore, I think we are strong enough to compete in combat, and I would love to be one of those women to do that.
Well, they'd love it, too.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you, Megan. All right, Robin Sprague, your question.
Okay.
Oh, I had this out of order. I'm sorry. Your fact sheet states you studied in London.
Right.
How did you benefit by the experience?
It was such an incredible experience because my classes were all about the British culture. So I would have an assignment such as, you know, Robin, you need to go out and go to the British Museum and write a paper about it. And I thought, oh, this is great. So I immersed myself in their culture, and that was a great benefit to me, to live in a big city that was very much different than my own.
Good answer.
Thanks.
Robin, has the use of sex appeal in advertisements gone too far?
Absolutely. As I said earlier on in the week, many parents are not home to be regulating the type of television that their children are watching. So it's very important that as consumers, we make sure that there's not sex and violence on television.
I agree with you. You betcha.
Who's next?
Kelly? Aha, I am going backwards.
Hi.
Kelly, your career ambition is broadcast journalism. If you're not successful in that field, how will you handle failure?
Oh, I definitely wouldn't look at it as failure. That's what I would like to do. But my heart lies in having a family. And if I don't succeed as a broadcaster, that's quite perfectly fine with me. I will get married and have a family and raise children of my own.
Good. Now, Kelly, how would you sell good citizenship to a juvenile delinquent?
Can you please restate that one more time?
Sure. How would you sell good citizenship to a juvenile delinquent?
My goodness. Mm-hmm. Well, we do have a major problem with our juveniles. But I think that if we show them by example how important it is to be a part of your community and to be a citizen and to believe in your country, I think it's very important, and we can show our children through example.
Mm-hmm. Lizette Gonzalez, you list broadcast journalism and performing on Broadway as career choices. If you were offered top roles in both career choices, which one would you choose and why?
Well, I would have to choose broadcast journalism because I believe we're all placed on this earth to make a difference, to leave a mark. And I think that nowadays the media is focusing too much on negative things that are occurring. Crime, juvenile delinquents, and we need to draw attention to that, but I'd like to draw attention to positive things, such as the Miss America organization, where all these wonderful, incredible, talented, intelligent women are giving back to the community. And as a broadcast journalism, there's a new story, a new experience, new people to meet every day. And I'm just a very curious, expressive, outgoing person, and I'd love to work on TV just in the field of communication.
Are you for or against government support of the arts?
Oh,
or should the arts be funded by the private sector?
I think that the private sector and the government should fund the arts. Before my platform was promoting unity through the celebration of cultural diversity, my platform was cultural awareness, confidence, and creativity in children through the arts. Because I believe that children can not only be proud of who they are in expressing themselves through art, not only can they gain confidence and self-esteem, they can also just express themselves through art if they have no other means of doing so. Thank you.
Well, now, Miss Tampa, I'm finally back to you.
You took the long way around.
Terry, yes. You have worked for the Violence Against Women organization. What were your responsibilities?
Well, when I worked in the Violence Against Women office at the U.S. Department of Justice, I assisted the director of that office, Bonnie Campbell, and helped her prepare for her speaking engagement. She traveled all over the country speaking to judges, prosecutors, people in the justice system, telling them about domestic violence and what they could do to get to eliminate it. And I helped her prepare for that, and by watching her example and seeing what a difference she was making, I realized what a difference I could make by doing the same thing and educating people about domestic violence. Thank you.
Well, what is your view on capital punishment?
Well, I believe in capital punishment. I believe that there are certain crimes, murder, that are carried out in such a heinous and just inhuman way that the only proper and just punishment that we can really give those individuals who commit those crimes is the death penalty.
Well, thank you. Now where do we go?
Commercial? Commercial?
They didn't tell me what we do now.
You have to stand up and entertain.
Okay.
I guess we're
all done,
really. Well, I tell you what, that moment is almost upon us. We are about to announce the runners-up in the 1998 Miss Florida. But before we do, I would be remiss if I didn't recognize the young lady who stood on this very stage 1 year ago at this very moment going through the same nerves that these ladies are going through and captured the town. Christy Newman represented our state wonderfully. We are proud of you, Christy. Congratulations on a wonderful year. And we wish you all the best. All the best. Well, are we ready? Do we have an envelope? We don't. Well, Barbara?
Yes, Debbie?
Do you have any jokes to tell?
That's what I'm here for.
Okay. I tell you what we can do. We can have Christy. Why don't you come over with a mic, and we'll share a mic with you, Christy.
Yes.
Tell us what your plans are next, what you'll be doing after tonight.
Well, actually, it's been a year filled with so many wonderful opportunities. I've had the opportunities to speak all over the Sunshine State to so many different people, and the experiences have been wonderful. I've spoken about my platform, Eating Disorder Awareness. But now, as my year as Miss Florida comes to an end, I will move on to other things. I plan to finish my college education, getting married next month.
Oh, congratulations.
Exciting.
Wonderful.
And also, I will probably be making a move to the Orlando area, and I've accepted a job with TravelQuest. So it's a new television company, and it's an interactive television company. So I'm very excited about that. A lot of new opportunities.
That's fantastic. We wish you all the best. And while we have
Thank you very much.
That's right. This is Christy Newman, ladies and gentlemen. Isn't she wonderful?
Thank you.
That's for you.
Thank you.
We would like to remind everyone to be sure and tune in September 19th. On ABC for the Miss America telecast, whoever we crowned this evening, will be representing the Sunshine State at the 1998 Miss America pageant. So be sure, you can go ahead and set your VCR now. You can set it this far in advance. That's all right, isn't it, Barbara?
Sure.
And you're going to tune in, of course?
Of course I am.
Do you watch the Miss America pageant?
Yes, I do. Yes.
And who's your favorite Miss America?
You, Debbie.
All right. You said the right thing, girl.
You, Debbie.
And you're my favorite genie.
It is September 19th, so be sure and check your local listing so you can tune in and support your Miss Florida. And also, just keep an eye out all year long because she will travel the state wide if she doesn't become Miss America all year, speaking at schools and at all sorts of civic and public events. Miss Florida's a hard worker, isn't she?
Absolutely. I've had about 145 appearances in the past year. It's a wonderful opportunity. Not to mention, I've also earned about $42,000, which will pay for my entire college education.
And that's what
been
this
a blessing.
Program is
it really
all
has
about.
Been.
That is exactly what this program is all about.
Well, Christy, since we have the time to talk, did you have a favorite appearance or someone that you met that you'll just never forget for the rest of your life?
You know, I did a lot of exciting appearances that would seem glamorous. I've done promotions for Pantene, did a live Jacksonville Jaguar rally in my own home city of Jacksonville, and I performed at that. And I've done some exciting things. I christened a ship, so I'm now the godmother of the Palm Beach Princess. That was exciting. But, you know, Debbie, to be honest, the most rewarding part of my year has been the little appearances where I've been able to actually touch people's lives. Planting those little seeds, even though it wasn't changing the world, just trying to make a difference one person at a time. That's what's been a blessing to me this year.
And that is indeed what it's all about. Very good. Very good.
It's also important to note that although we're going to crown one Miss Florida and four runners-up, there are 35 other contestants here on stage that have worked hard all year long, and they deserve to be recognized, too. You've done a beautiful job, lady. As well, you can keep your eye out for them during the year, even though they might leave the stage not being Miss Florida. They're still their local title holder, and they'll be working in their own communities, promoting their own platform, as well as promoting the Miss Florida Scholarship Pageant. And so that's a job all into itself.
It absolutely is. All of these contestants have done their own community service in their own cities at the local level. So it's a wonderful organization that truly does breed well-rounded young women.
And thank the Lord, we have the result. May I have
We will have a new Miss Florida.
Please.
I was beginning to think I just got to keep it for another year.
Yeah,
so.
Maybe you would at this rate, wouldn't it?
Thank you, sir. Kind sir.
All right, Barbara, we'll let you have your mic back.
Oh, gee, thanks.
Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, the fourth runner-up to Miss Florida is Kelly Gaudet, Miss Palm Beach County.
The second runner-up, the third runner-up, is contestant number Robin Sprague, Miss South Florida Fair.
And the second runner-up is Megan Berry, Miss Florida State University.
The first runner-up is Carrie Schrader, Miss Tampa.
Oh, my God. Ladies and gentlemen, your new Miss Florida. Stands Lizette Gonzalez, Miss Miami.